Okay, horse people. Mr. T's sleeping over there. He's a little back leg. I just picked his feet. But he's cleaning up the weeds. Want to do a couple little trailer tips. I hadn't really looked at my trailer since I got back. And I mentioned a few things sometime. And I got a few questions. I never really covered it. So I figured I'd go over them one time real quick. I keep this rope here to hold my door open. So, you know, when you open your tack room door, the wind will blow it, and then it snaps, and it bounces and bangs shut, and it'll bring your hook. So this rope right here, I always keep this rope to where it's tied to here, and then I just set it over my little jack, and that way it holds that door and keeps that door from swinging. And then the second way the rope does it is I always keep a nice little D-ring, and you can pick one of these up pretty cheap at REI or one of your other climbing or rappelling stores. And I mean, I get a regular D-ring that I can climb off of, so if I had to tie something and rappel off something, that's strong enough to do it. Those things are pretty strong. I forgot what they use, a different type of measuring system, K or something, double K, whatever. I'd have to look it up. I haven't been into it, but basically it's a D-ring, and it's got a clip. It's not gonna rust. So I just leave it on the side, and that way if I have to clip my horse in real quick, or if I have to click this, I just put this loop around here, I hook it to the back of this door, and this keeps my door secured open. And the reason why I do this is several reasons. One is if I'm airing it out, one, after I wash it when I get back, I want to let it air out and dry as quick as it can so moisture doesn't stay in there and mold, etc. So I usually just leave the door open. So that rope comes in handy for that. Also, if I'm doing any trail loading with a new horse or a horse that I don't want the door swinging and scaring him, I want that door good and secure. I don't want somebody having to hold it, because if somebody holds it, they're standing right there, and that's creating more pressure for a horse to enter a trailer. So when you're doing trailer loading, always tie your door or figure out a way to keep your door to where it doesn't blow shut. I know some doors have little locks. That's okay. As long as your door doesn't swing loose, or you don't have to have somebody standing right there where you're trying to get the horse going to, because when you've got somebody standing by the trailer, it creates pressure, and then the horse not as worried about the trailer, he's worried about the other human, and he don't want to hit the human, and he doesn't want to step on him, he doesn't want to get kicked, he doesn't know what they're going to do, he's trying to listen to you, and he's trying to get in a trailer, and just puts that extra, you want to remove everything you can to make trailer loading easy. So, and then, so of course, the other little thing that I did is, I was looking after I rode over here, and these wires right here, when you buy a trailer from the thing, you're going to see exposed wires. And that's normal, and that's for the lights, and it's usually cheap little wires. So basically, I went around, anytime I found some exposed wires, I just put some black electrical tape on it. And electrical tape's pretty easy, just wrap it around. It gives a little bit extra protection from the elements. If the sun hits it, it's not going to rot your wiring. Your wiring has a rubber coating, but that sun can rot that. And if it's rotting or cracked, and you wrap it with electrical tape, that'll give it some extra protection, even after it starts to crack. But if you do it before, then it won't crack. So any place you see wiring, you want to go ahead and try to wrap that. And while I'm talking here, I just missed that one. I don't even know if you can see that. I got what's underneath here. See that wire? I didn't see that when I was wrapping these other ones. So now I got to wrap that one. And that's what the exposed wire looks like. And if you look at this little thing right here where they clamp two wires together, putting that electrical tape over that will stop moisture and rust from getting in there. So that's another good reason to go ahead and wrap those. I don't even know if you can see it. There you go. Maybe you can see it. All right. And then the other thing that I did is I noticed after I cleaned this out that my wood, they had it painted a little bit from the factory. So I found some, and of course, if I went out and bought good paint, it would have matched. I would have bought white. But I was cheap, and there was some paint left over in the house when I just got it. And it was exterior. And so I went ahead and used it since it was good exterior paint. And basically I just painted the top after I cleaned it. You probably want to pressure wash it. If you don't have a pressure washer, just clean it real good with the hose, let it dry, make sure it's nice and clean. And then go ahead and paint it. And what that does is when I put my mats back over here, it's going to stop the urine, if it gets under the mat, from soaking into the wood, making the wood. I'm still going to get on the bottom. I didn't paint the bottom. If I would have done it like I should have, like the factory should, I should either pull these boards out, paint them top and bottom with a good oil base or a nice good stain. You know, a lot of people say use Thompson water seal. I've heard a lot of things about that it's kind of It's kind of cheap and it doesn't work real good and it washes off quick. And if you don't do it every year, and underneath this board here, the water and the dirt and the grime and the road debris and everything is bouncing and the wind's blowing. So, I don't know. Somebody who's out there is a painter who might know a better paint to put on this. I've heard some people put the same kind of stuff they put on their truck bed. If you want to pay the money, it's pretty expensive, but they can put that truck bed coating underneath, and that way the dirt and the grime won't wash it off, and that'll really protect the wood from getting urine, dirt, oil, transmission fluid, everything that you run through. So when it rains and your tires are rolling and everything's blowing up on the dirt, that all gets in your wood and it weakens your wood. So this, just to me, it's not so much for looks, if obviously, or I would have painted it white. I'm sure when one of my buddies sees this, they're going to call me a lazy country hick for not matching the color. But anyway, I just wanted a cover of painting across here, paint, to help give it extra protection from, because every time I load my horses and I put them out, I wash my trailer. So this is constantly getting wet pretty much every time I use it. I'm washing out the poop, I'm washing out the water, or the urine, and I'm getting it wet from the water. Also, when your horse is in here, it's getting wet from the poop. They're nervous, so their poop's usually a little bit more runny. So that poop kind of washes down on the floor, and it gets in your wood, and it soaks in, and it just weakens it over time. By putting a coat of paint or something over it, kind of helps it. Okay, so those are my little trailer tips. Hope that helps. We'll end that there. Buddy, where'd he run off to? Damn horse is into something. He's going to be in the kitchen in a minute cooking dinner. Don't you go in that kitchen, boy, where I got the apples. He's playing with his birds. Boy, Mr. T, what are you doing? He's like, dude, don't put me in that trailer. All right, we'll end that there.